Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to rebuild you once again. Hope this time I can build you right. Punch the gas and you'll take a flight. Hit the pedal to the floor. Hope you won't bog anymore. You'll hear the sound of thunder.
Cruising in my lane fast, call it high speed. I've been working hard, yeah, I've been working nightly. If you think you'll win, ha, not fucking likely. I be taking shots, yeah, cold-blooded, icy. Watching numbers grow is what I call sightseeing. In the front row, run it up when they hype me. The following grows, they know how to ignite me. Call me CEO, I've been running shit right, see.
Hey, guys and girls, welcome back to the channel. In today's episode, we will be rebuilding a Quadrajet. Here we have two different versions. Actually, they're the same version, just two different carburetors off of two different cars. On the right, we have a Carter Quadrajet off of a 79 Camaro. On the left, we have a Carter Quadrajet off a 79 Corvette 350 version. So the first thing you're going to notice is this one has four pickup tubes, this one has six. And the reason for this is because of the 350 Corvette, a little more high output, more performance engine, needed that little more gas in it. But basically, we're going to be taking the best of both carburetors and making one pretty wicked Quadrajet. We're going to be using mostly the Corvette carb, the air horn up here, the middle body. But we're going to be using the base plate for this one off of the Camaro because it's in better shape. I've already drilled out or... Basically, from my last video, you'll notice I've already drilled out the access to the fuel air mixture screws here and here. You know, this isn't easy pointing from the camera. Anyway, for the air fuel mixture screws, we'll be using all that stock setup for the base plate. And we will be using the choke off of this carburetor because it's in much better condition than this one was, and this all has new parts in it anyway. So we're gonna yank this choke off, slap it into this one. That'll be our first order of attack. Then we will start slapping this back together with all these parts and the kits that I have and everything. So I'm gonna give you a how-to video, how to rebuild a Quadrajet and make her nasty. So let's get started, shall we? I'll get set up and then we'll get rolling. All right. It's time to start putting this thing together. Basically, we're gonna be taking off of this choke. So we're gonna be taking off our little, this is a hot electric, or what they call hot air choke system. It will feed off of a tube that comes off of here and goes down to the intake, and with vacuum and everything, it'll heat up this spring that's inside here, which will raise your choke rod here, which is attached to this, and it opens up your throttle blade. I could transfer this over to electric, but I'm trying to keep the car basically stock for the most part. I like the hot air choke system. They work well if everything's in working condition, and mine happens to be. So we're gonna keep it like it is and not transfer it over to electric. I'm more old school anyway. I prefer everything old school. Things were made better, simpler, lasted longer. So this is held on by just three screws with these little retainers. Then this will come off, which will reveal the little spring that heats up inside our gasket right here, which is new, so we're gonna keep that all together. This little slot will go inside of this, and that's what raises and choke up and down. Now we can take this rest of the choke body off with all these little doohickeys with it. Let me get a little bigger screwdriver on this. I've already taken this choke all the way apart. We've installed the new gaskets behind here. There's actually two, and a little plastic piece as well. There's a screw for that. This all just slides off. It'll all stay attached. But behind here, actually right behind this, you take this little Phillips out and this will all come off, and there will be a little rubber gasket back there, which kind of looks like that. It'll be one of these little black ones that you see here, and it goes behind there. And you'll also need another rubber gasket that will go here, which we've already installed on this one, but now we're going to be putting it on the other one. So now we got our choke off. We can slap it over here out of the way till we're ready for it. We could use this one because this is brand new, hasn't even been used yet. I'll be able to probably just pull it out with these little needle nose without damaging it. There we go. Little rubber gasket like such. They should be at least two in your kit. Sometimes they'll have three, I noticed, but one goes there, just push it in. One goes behind there. So let's insert that. Well, let me get one more thing here. Will be our actual arm itself. And this here, basically, will be like that down inside. And then this choke will slide through here in conjunction with this, and that's what controls your choke arm. So now this, take off like that, remember how it goes, and this will pretty much be done with this one. So we're gonna set that to the side. We'll bring the new one over that we're going to be using, the new main body. We're going to insert this, and you'll see one side's completely flat, and the other side will be, there'll be like a little slit all the way around it. That'll go on the inside. You want the flat, solid part on the outside. So we'll stick it in there. And you could lube these up too if you wanted to. Put a little WD-40 on it or something. I happen to drop it, so. There we go. It just pushes right in, sits in there nice and flush. You're good to go. So that part's done. Now we can install, and this is already pretty much set, but if you needed to know how it went, you want the green part. Mine happens to be green, but you want it in this little white thing. There'll also be in your kit. This new one here, which I happen to have two kits, so I've already put a new one in here, but that little white tab will come out and it goes into there, just slides right in, put it in, and it fits down in here. So basically, this is the hardest part of, I feel, that the rebuild part is stabbing this and getting that white tab in its position and getting everything to line up just like you want with this here, because basically this will be on here like that. It'll attach together like this, and that's what will help open and close your choke rod. So it has to be fed in, and then down here hold it in and line it all up. You can put the carburetor sideways to do that if you wanted to. I've seen people do that before. I'm gonna actually go out. You can do it like this as well, but I'm actually gonna go out and the trick I use is I put a magnet here. I gotta go get it, but I'll put a magnet here, hold this down in there, line it all up, put it together. All right, we're back with our little magnet. Basically what I do is I'll put this magnet on here, hold it like this so I can hold it level and parallel or horizontal, and slap it in there to where I can line everything up. And to do that, we'll get it started. It's basically gonna go like this. We're gonna get it started with this little white tab. This will go in there, and then the white tab will basically line up with this. And once we get everything lined up just right, like such, and get it started, at this point I'll take my magnet. Actually, I'm gonna put a little tool underneath it. It works great, even easier if you've got like a carburetor base plate where you can hold it on there, but I don't do enough carburetors for that, so I haven't ever bought one. I just stick a hammer or a screwdriver or something underneath it, prop up the carburetor. So now that we got it started, I can slap this down. Actually, I'm gonna put it back here more where I got a better visual. We'll put it down there and stab her home like that. And I missed it. Interesting. I never miss. Okay. There, now I can see better. I don't know if I'm giving y'all a good visual on this. I hope so. Pull it up here a little more. I think that would be better. I got it started. Okay, I need to have it at a little angle. So I gotta put it in at a little angle, then we'll be in business. Now we're in business. Okay. Now I want to make sure everything is in its proper hole. So what we're gonna do is flip it over a little bit. Yes, okay, everything went in. We're all butted up here, here, and in the center. And our rod's on. We can go ahead and attach our little rod arm here. It only fits in one hole. So there's that. Now we can see it's actually working, moving up and down. So that portion's done. Now I want to just visually check everything. Yep, everything's still in place. Okay, we're in there. Our rod came out, but I'll put that back in. I just want to make sure everything nice and flush. Okay, now we can put our screw back in here that holds it all together right here. We'll start it by hand. Oh, one thing I am leaving out. This is a no-no. Forgot to stick our little arm on here, so this little arm goes on it like that, or this little lever, and it actually goes just like this, and it'll mount onto this right here. But we have enough room here, I believe, to where we can squeeze that in. There we go. Now it's in place. Now we can tighten this choke system up. Make sure everything's still lined up. Our rod's still attached. Our little plastic pin is in. And we're all sealed up there. Now we can tighten the screw up. We'll just get it started by hand. Tighten our home. Alright, now our choke's in. Everything's still working. So that looks good. Give it another visual real quick. The little plastic piece that I told you about. This little plastic here. That white one. It actually is here inside. That's all lined up. Our rod fell off, but that's no big deal. I can put that back on anytime. Everything is in place. So our choke is in place. We're going to go ahead and torque it down now. See, I see it's just a hair off of center. And I'm a nut. I like everything to be centered, squared, in proper form. This is off just a hair. There we go. I feel better about that. Now we'll torque that down real good. Boom. Now our choke's in. Okay. Everything went well there. There. Basically, you want to make sure this is a little plastic made it into that slot. Either your arms are still all free and able to move. That your pin, that little lever inside, is still attached, and that this is still free to move. And if you got all that, then you're in, you're aligned. She went in well. So now we'll stick our little attachment arm. It goes like this, you know, that little slot, and then that, now we're attached again. Okay. Now we can put our cover back on. Now there's a gasket. There's this gasket here that comes with the kit. I've already put a new one on here, so this is my gasket from the kit. You want to put that, you want to take the old gasket off, of course, and you want to put your new one on. Then you want to line. Now when you first took it off, you could have took a note of where your It's got little notches here, and on this it'll say rich this way counterclockwise, and this way clockwise would lean the carburetor out. But this little slot on the spring will go into this little slot here. So you want to line that up, and there's a notch on your out cover, on your cover of your choke. This little notch, you'll see when you first take it off, I made a note of it. Mine was one notch. There's three notches on both sides of the center. Like that would be centered. I had one notch lean. So I'm gonna mark it basically like it was. Try to line this up. All right, now we're lined up pretty good. Mine was one notch, so I'm gonna pretty much leave it like it was. You can always adjust this later. Like, we're gonna put this under vacuum gauge, dial it in, and we can adjust this choke once we get it on the carburetor and get it in a cold start, make sure our flap is closed and all that. So basically it was like right there. So choke should be done now. Now we can put our little retaining clips back on here. You get three of them. A lot of new kits will have the new ones, will have you some new ones in here. Mine happened to be pretty big and bulky looking. So I'm just going back with the original. So we got one started. So now I will stick the second one on, get it started. And there'll be a little curve to it. I don't know if you can see it, if it's gonna pick up here, but there will be like a little curve to this flange, if you will. And you want it to curve in to where it's actually pinching this cover. And that's what holds it down. You don't have to torque them down or nothing crazy, but you want them snug. And they just kind of fit around it perfectly and holds it down snug for you. Get it lined up. There we go. Snug these down, and that will be the end of our choke. Our choke will be put together in working order onto the new mid body that we'll be using. So now our choke's all together. Choke rod fell out again, of course, and it will. That's not a big deal. You can slap this in and out anytime you need it. I like to put it in there, keep it in there once I start putting it together. So our choke's working. All the little adjusters are moving and in working order. So we're good. It's got a little spring tension, so I know I'm in here. If this is just flopping up and down with no tension, then that means you missed your little notch inside where you put the spring in. So that's how you know you got your spring in here inside attached and everything. Now we've got that portion done. We can get onto the base plate and get it ready for mounting. So let me move some of these tools here so we can bring our base plate in to focus. And there's not much here. I've already cleaned it. Everything's in working order. Everything's opening up well. But we need to insert our air fuel mixer screws. And that's what we're going to be doing next. Now I cleaned our needles and everything. Clean the springs. So we're going to screw these in. This happened to be a 3/16 hex. So we're going to, I got to go get that tool, which I left out, and to insert these. And then once we insert these, then we can put our gasket on and put the base plate and the mid body together. So let me go get that hex tool. And
I'll be cruising in my lane fast, call it high speed. I've been working hard, yeah, I've been working nightly. If you think you'll win, ha, not fucking likely. I be taking shots, yeah, cold-blooded, icy. Watching numbers grow is what I call sightseeing. In the front row, run it up when they hype me. The following grows, they know how to ignite me. Call me CEO, I've been running shit right, see.